Let's say amen for God's sake.
Okay, just before we get into the word, yesterday was a great day, prayer vigil from 8 to 12. And the Lord said, was just, we will allow just a few moments for you that were here just to have a few minutes just to share your experience yesterday. All right, Sister Deborah.
Good morning, family.
Good morning.
Amen. We're so thankful for what the Lord is doing in our prayer vigil. Amen. Each one may be different. Amen. I got an outpouring of words of encouragement and lives were changed. And so that's what matters. Amen. And so we're thankful for the vigil. The next one will be March the 26th. Asking you to prepare your hearts and your calendar to be here from 8 until noon. But I was really blessed by Minister Denise McClellan's testimony. She texted me on last night and just really blessed my heart. So I'm wondering if she will come today and just share what she experienced. The core of it, of the vigil, is not only to draw us closer to the Lord, but also give us a heart to intercede. Amen. And I believe what took place yesterday took some people, if they received it, to another level in the area of intercessory prayer. Minister Denise.
God bless you, Minister Moore. I texted Debbie on yesterday, and I told her how the impact made on my life seeing the video. And it was so much so that I just couldn't get it out of my mind. And the Holy Spirit took me to scriptures pertaining to persecutions, and I'm a person that memorized the word all the time, and it's just like those scriptures, most of them I had already put in me, and it just rekindled that fire. And so much so that I went a little bit further. I went online and I thank you, Jesus. I began to pull up videos concerning the persecuted Christians. This is real, saints. Here we are in America. We're so free to open our Bibles and lift our hands and worship God any time of day. We forget about them until somebody brings it to our remembrance. I told Debbie, I said, thank God that you obeyed him. Even now, I'm so emotional because the video, excuse me, made an impact on me. You know, they have given a greater mandate for missionaries and the persecuted Christians to go and minister. And we're just given the lesser mandate. We're just commanded to pray for them. So I said, Holy Spirit, please just consume me with the spirit of prayer. Not only those that are going to different countries to minister your gospel, but for those, like someone mentioned yesterday, our neighbors, our co-workers, we don't want them saints to go to hell. We don't want them to be persecuted. And I was reminded of even Paul. Remember, before his conversion, how he persecuted the church. And I'm sure the apostles prayed for him, and look what God did for him. Even Jesus told us in Matthew, blessed are you when men shall revile you and shall persecute you and say all manner of evil against you falsely for my name's sake. But he said, rejoice. Rejoice. Because great is your reward. Since I believe if they're getting a great reward, how much more we pray for them, are we going to also get a reward? I just want to encourage you on this morning, because I'm just really stirred. And I just said, Holy Spirit, please don't let this leave me. Oftentimes, you know, In meetings like this, we are stirred right from the beginning. Then two or three later years down the road, we get a little cool. I said, I don't want to ever get cool down. Because people are giving their very lives for the sake of Christ. Even as I speak right now, I just want you to know that we just need to get a little bit more serious. And I'm talking to me first. God bless you.
Is there another one?
Yesterday was our second prayer vigil, and I tell you, I come expecting to give. I also come expecting to receive. And so I was saying to the Lord, I'm just a little greedy right now. I'm open. Whatever you want to do, whatever you want to say, however you want to say it, I'm just open. At one point, Sister Deborah talked about the purpose of spiritual warfare. And you know that if you're in a war, you've got an enemy. And sometimes we just kind of blow our enemy off. We seem to think that if we don't mention him, if we don't acknowledge him, he won't acknowledge us. Well, that's just not the case. That's just not the case. Our enemy is not each other. Our enemy is Satan. And the Bible says he comes to kill, to steal, and to destroy. And that's what he sets out to do. But I just want to highlight this because it just spoke to my heart. Three-dimensional, we're living in a three-dimensional world. And she said one is the social battle. Her scriptures was St. John 15:18 through 27. And it's the hate of the world. We're not to hate each other. Our enemy is Satan. And, but we do have people who hate us simply because we love the Lord. There are people who want to destroy us because we acknowledge. You know, sometimes on our jobs, we don't go along with the dirty jokes. We don't go along with the cussing. We just don't go along. And after a while, if we find ourselves separating from that. Not that we are better than anybody. That's not it at all. It's just that you just don't want that mess in your spirit. You just don't want it. You don't want to have to deal with it. And then she talked about the second one. But let me back up a minute. They hated Jesus first without a cause. And so anytime you exemplify Jesus, anytime you have the character of Christ, more than likely, you may not know it. You may not know it. You may not even know that on your job, folk are watching and they are checking you out and they notice you ain't telling no dirty jokes and you ain't sitting around those that do. But then the second one was flesh and spirit. Galatians 5:16 through 23. And just our war is against our own flesh a lot of times. Our war is against our own minds a lot of times. What took place when we were younger or things that happened in our lives? Satan likes to use that. He likes to bring it back up and make you think you're not saved and make you think you're not this and you're not that. And he throws this stuff up in your face. And then at some point, we go, you have to take authority and you have to tell him, okay, back up. We done it all that. I've been delivered. I've been set free. I've been forgiven. Back up. I don't even accept that mess anymore. And then her third one, against evil powers. Ephesians 6:10 through 24 and 2 Timothy 3 through 3 and 1. We war against against principalities and powers, the hierarchies of the enemy. And I'm telling you, babies, he doesn't care what he uses. He doesn't care who he uses. What this book so to me, the purpose of spiritual warfare, it so spoke to me because, again, we seem to take a lot of stuff for granted. We take Bible reading for granted when we don't even understand that is our weapon. That is our weapon. That is our weapon. Mornings, getting in the presence of the Lord. Morning, reading your Bible. Morning, praying. Spending time with God. Getting instructions from God. We seem to take that for granted. We're busy. We are. We're busy. We got this job. We got that to do. And what we don't realize is that we have to start. We have to start. It can be. Now, I'm not trying to give you a schedule. That's between you and God. But I am saying, at some point of part of the day, you've got to spend your time with God. You've got to hear from him. You've got to find out what he wants you to do, who he wants you to do it with, what he wants you to say. Thank you.
Saturday morning was my first opportunity to come because of work. That kind of overshadowed everything what I'm about to say. That video that Sister Deb showed, I mean, it's kind of hard here to, you have to see it. If we can get that and just show it during the service, it's very humbling. We all know about the news media touched on the fact that ISIS beheaded a bunch of people. But they didn't really emphasize that those people that they beheaded were Christian. It's not us that are going over there that are dying. It's the Christians that are already there in Syria and Africa. They're giving their lives for standing. Standing for the word. It really hit me because being here, it humbled me. I got to complaining. I recently lost the position. I was turned down. You know what the reason was? I'm too sensitive. I have it in paper. I have it in writing. They said I was too sensitive. What I was too sensitive to, that they consider being too sensitive for, is I didn't put up with the cussing, the bad jokes. I would walk away and get into my own environment. I didn't allow them to cuss around me. One particular individual I had to really challenge because he wanted to call me Mike. My name is Michael. Not Mike. If you understand what Michael means, you think I want to give that up for Mike, who you can give anything? I'm Michael, servant of the Lord. And every time you call me by my name, it reminds me who I am. But I got to complaining because I had lost that. And then I saw the video. And understand that we really got to pray. We're going through some stuff here. We're being denied some things here. It's getting worse here because we're Christian, because we love the Lord. But we really got to pray, because what's going on over there, if we don't pray, if we don't humble ourselves, it's coming here. Did everybody know that a couple of years ago, what's the Jewish, not Jewish, but the Muslim law, Sharia law, or whatever you call it, was on the ballot. Sharia law was on the ballot here in Oklahoma. The Bible Belt. How did it even get to the ballot? That's my question. How did it even get to the ballot? But if one thing, just, I don't want to take too much time because I did it once before, but... We really do need to humble ourselves and really start praying for the saints, period. Praying for each other, praying for saints around the world, praying for the saints here, because in denying me that position, they denied me a slight raise, which means my tithes goes up, which means that's money going into building the kingdom. And that's ultimately what Satan is trying to do. But God turned around, brought back to my remembrance everything I had to learn, set me before a panel where I had to take a test and explain to them every machine that was going on. They tried to take me beyond what I was supposed to know, the understanding that I got a mighty God, the Holy Spirit, to know how to bring things back to remembrance. They sat there thinking I was going to be dumbfounded because they think they're going to ask me something I didn't know. And I expounded upon it, and they sat there with their mouths open. That, getting through that, now I got a $3.30 raise. So to dial me that position was one thing on a raise, but they cannot deny you what the Lord has put in you. They cannot deny it. But all that came through prayer. Praying for the saints. And I understand somebody probably was praying for me. My wife was praying for me. But we need to pray for each other. We really do need to pray for each other, because the devil is subtle. He doesn't come in and bang you over the head. He comes in with a little bit and it feels good. We used to have a saying, well, I grew up in low income. I'm called ghetto. Low income, and one way we avoided the dope pushers, we had a saying: the first one's always free. The first one's always free. But second, with Satan, the first one is always good. But he's real subtle. He's real subtle, and he's doing some subtle things, tearing down some things. So I ask you for Denise and I our prayer, because we're doing something. We're tearing down, and a lot of people don't understand, because we're taking the youth and we're making them like Jews. We're focusing them on the word instead of the play. So when they get of age, hopefully they know more of the Bible than more hip hop. Right now we got kids that know too much about hip hop, not enough for the Bible. 90% of my youth, when they reach college, lose their religion. Why? Because they know too much about hip-hop and not enough about Bible. I bet you I can go to some of you right now and ask you right now to justify and defend your faith. How many of us can do it? How many of us can do it? But keep us in prayer. Pray for each other. And if she, Sister Deborah can get that, we really need to watch it. Because there's some things going on around this world we need to know about. They don't put it on the media. That are happening to Christians. Particularly in Africa and in the Middle East. Thank you.
All right. Wasn't that good?